Hello, everyone, and welcome in. Hope everyone is doing well. Positive healing vibes to all the subscribers, the viewers, the world out there. Today, we're going to start with Gemini's secret spy tarot spread. In this message, we are first going to tap into these energies with the romance angels. Then we are going to use a traditional deck to dive into the situation, okay? We're going to get an overview message for what the situation is. We'll take a look into what your partner's intention, your partner, person of interest, love, friend, friend with benefits. Take a look at their intentions. We'll take a look at how they feel, what they're not telling you. Get some advice moving forward. I'll also clarify the message. I always pull a few oracle cards at the end. If that's something you're interested in, you are more than welcome in joining. Everyone is always welcome here. Please keep in mind, guys, the messages here on YouTube are general. They are not going to resonate every time with every person. You are more than welcome to check other signs. It's really about the title. If there's something in the title resonating, there's most likely going to be something in the message. For more information on how to book a personal reading, the energy cleanse kits offered, how to get entered into the drawing we do here every month, all that other helpful information is linked below. And Gemini, if you like how I vibe, you like how I interpret the cards, you are more than welcome to subscribe. Everyone is welcome here. And it does help set your intentions for future messages. So, Gemini. On the bottom, we have make the effort. Great love is worth taking the steps you're guided to take. Chemistry. There is a strong magnetic attraction here. Stay optimistic about your love life. Positive thinking and faith will bring you romance, attraction. I feel like this is a new person coming into your life. You attract romantic love by enjoying this moment fully. There may be something, somebody coming your way, maybe you're going on a date. I feel like it's like a walk in the park. And there's a need to kind of stay present, stay in the moment. Say yes. I just heard say yes. Let's take a look. Let's take a look here, Gemini. This is interesting. Somebody new coming your way. Do feel like there is chemistry here. This is a person that you have chemistry with. Feel like this is somebody who this could work out very sweetly for you, Gemini. Let's see. For Gemini, for the month of June, what does Gemini need to see here for the month of June regarding this new person coming in? What is the situation at hand? Please and thank you. Feel like you are moving. There's a lot of movement here. You get the sense that you're also working on something. This person may be coming towards you, maybe traveling towards you. I feel like you have been working on yourself emotionally. We have the Queen of Cups, Eight of Pentacles, and the Six of Swords. So there's something that you have been working on within yourself. Getting yourself more emotionally grounded, emotionally stable. Feel like there is something also that you're moving forward from, okay? Something that you're leaving behind. And just focusing on work here, Jem. Focusing on, you know, minding your own business, I feel. And then along came a spider. Do you feel like this person that's coming in may very well be somebody that you've manifested? We have the Magician and the Two of Cups that just came out. Okay. I feel like this is your energy, Gemini. This person that's coming in is somebody that you've manifested into your life. This is somebody that maybe not exactly this specific person, but I feel like they may have a lot of characteristics, a lot of attributes that may be similar to things that you've thought about wanting in your own partner, okay? This person may have a lot of options, okay? But I feel like there may be one option, Gemini, you, that kind of stands out the most. And I do feel like this is more of a friendly relation. This is more of like a newer relationship, something that's very friendly, more than actually in that long-term commitment, okay? I do see there is potential here. This person does have their eye on you, okay? Let's take a look a little bit deeper into this person's intentions here, Gemini. What is this person's intentions for the month of June, Spirit? So they may be traveling towards you. Okay, you may be at a distance from them. I feel like there's something strong that they're going to communicate, maybe bringing this to the next level. They want to take this to the next level with you. Let's get a clarifying card there for Gemini Spirit. Please clarify the Chariot in the World. Wish fulfillment. You're something that they've had their eye on for a while. Get the sense here, Gemini, that they want to take this to the next level. Let's take a look into your intentions, Gemini. What is Gemini thinking here, Spirit? What is Gemini's intentions? Oh. You're not ready for this. You're not ready for this, Gem. There's a sense that a new relationship kind of stresses you out, and there's still some type of heartache, loss that you're trying to release. I don't feel like you're ready. Let's get a clarifying card out here for the Nine of Swords with the Three of Swords in reverse. A lot of up in your head thinking, Jen. I hate to say focus on healing because Geminis have been healing for a while, but if you're still feeling stressed, anxious, if things are still triggering you, it's best to just take a step back and go within. Sometimes it can take a while, you know. Sometimes it takes a while to get recalibrated, especially if you've gone through something very tumultuous. Let's take a look at how they really feel, Gem. How does this person really feel here about Gemini Spirit? What is this person's true feelings towards Gemini? Please and thank you. How sweet. I feel like they want to help you. They want to help you heal. They may communicate this as well. They may communicate that they want to help you through this process here with the Star to the Eight of Wands. Clarify the Eight of Wands to the Star card, Spirit, please and thank you. feel like they know what you've been going through. They may have been watching you, watching, they may have been friends with you for a while, kind of watching from a distance, I feel like. I do feel like they know that you need healing though, Jem. Let's take a look at how you're feeling here. How is Gemini feeling about this situation, Spirit? What is Gemini feeling? What is Gemini's true feelings towards this person? I feel like you're kind of cautious. You don't... First of all, we have the Eight of Swords, so you're still feeling tied to a situation, feeling connected to a past situation. I feel like this is maybe what you're trying to heal from. But I do get the sense here, Gemini, we have the Fool coming out in reverse. It's like you're being very cautious, okay? You're not wanting to take too many risks here. The Fool in reverse is the sense that I'm getting. You're not willing to risk it. Let's clarify this. Death card. Still some significant changes I feel like you're going through, Gemini, and you may know that you still have these changes to make. That's why you're reluctant to move this forward with this person. What are they not telling, Gemini Spirit? What is not being said here? What is not being said between Gemini and this person? This is too many cards. We have Two of Wands, the Moon, Ace of Cups, Six of Pentacles, Judgment, Ten of Pentacles, Ace of Pentacles. There's a lot of pentacles here, I feel like, and there's a lot of healing. I feel like there's something that you're still focusing on within work, Gemini, that you're not feeling balanced. You're not feeling, the energy that I'm picking up is you want to be stable within your career before you focus on relationships. It's not being said here. Maybe that's something that you need to communicate. If that is pertaining to you. Yeah. So we have the Ten of Wands and the Page of Pentacles. There's definitely a need to talk about this financial situation. If you're not wanting a relationship, Gem, until your business takes off or your career comes together, then you need to say that. You need to speak that piece to this person. Let's get a clarifier. Yeah. Just tell them, Gemini, that we have the Eight of Pentacles, by the way, clarifying that. Just tell them that you're working on this project, career change, career move, business venture, however that's pertaining to you. Communication is going to be key. I do see that this is a friendly connection. So this is a person who very well could be a friend. Okay, soulmates don't necessarily have to be an intimate lover, love type connection. I do see there is potential for that in this, Gemini. But I get the sense here that you are kind of focused on healing and they're ready. And I get the sense you intuitively know you're not ready here. Okay. Let's pull a few cards out here for your advice, Gemini, moving forward. What is Gemini's advice here, Spirit? What is the advice here for Gemini for the month of June regarding this love? Interest. This person may be able to help you with whatever project, whatever business venture that you're working on, Gemini, but you might block that opportunity by not being open to this connection. You're going to do what's best for you. And I feel like that's what the key is here, is but expressing that, you know, letting this person know that you would rather, you know, be alone while you work on this project. You just want to be friends while you work on that project. Something along those lines, you know. Once I make X amount of dollars, then I'll want to work on a relationship. Right now, I'm kind of focused on my project. Nine of Pentacles, Page of Wands, okay? Communication is going to be key here. Either you guys have known each other for a long time, or there's a deep connection here, okay? But I feel like by communicating your peace, Gemini, that you're going to be withholding until you get this business venture off the ground or this career venture off the ground, it gives them the opportunity to make the decision if they want to stay or go. And they very well may decide to stay. Okay? Let's pull a few of these Island Time Wellness cards out here, Jen. I am going to do an extended version to this reading. In the extended version, I want to take a look at what the next steps are moving. What are the next steps here? I'm going to take a look at message from Spirit. We'll also pull a few cards for what the outcome between you two is. I'll pull the Archangel cards for the blessing, the Soul Truth for the lesson. If that's something you guys are interested in, you are more than welcome in joining. The link is below. So, the Island Time Wellness deck coming out for you guys. I feel like we have karmic relationship, we have date, and we have not enough. So, karmic relationship says meeting, triggers, turmoil, resentment, lessons, letting go, loving you. Date is meeting somebody new, getting back out there. Not enough is frustrated in relationships, lack of confidence, fear, ego issues. Feel like there is this kind of need to work on yourself. There may have been a relationship in your past that was tumultuous that you're healing from, and this is causing stagnancy. Express that. Say it. F it. What's the worst that can happen, right? This person comes towards you and wants to take this relationship to the next level, and you're not ready. You're going to have to communicate that, Gem. Okay, so Gemini, let's get a power thought card out here for you. We'll do the soul journey first. Been doing these soul journeys. I like these soul journey cards, so let's do it. If you guys are finding that this message is helpful, that it's resonating with your situation, give it a thumbs up. All the love and support is very much appreciated. It also helps the growth of the channel. If you guys do help, thank you guys so much. If you guys don't, thank you guys so much for watching. You guys are all amazing. So, Gemini, this is interesting. The card that's coming out for you out of the Soul Journey deck is Pride. So let me get it together for you. Pride. I love myself and I see myself in everyone. You need to take time to honor and acknowledge who you are and what your soul has accomplished with your life thus far. You should look at your past soul choices and be mindful of how, through your positive actions, compassion, and understanding, you have made a better life for yourself and others. How have you changed the world in some little way? How have you shared insight with others? Reflect on what you have mastered. You should never underappreciate or underestimate yourself or your accomplishments. Now is the time for you to remember how brave you have been throughout your journey. Celebration is required. Humans tend to spend too much of their energy and time on negative emotions or what they have not done. This card signifies that you should take rightful ownership of who you are and how you have shared your unique light with the world. It may also be a perfect time for you to look around and acknowledge those other souls who have also accomplished many great things and who need to be reminded of them. Sense of maybe you're feeling not as confident as you should be, Gemini, coming into your season. Take a step back and look back on how far you've come. Be proud of yourself. You might not be exactly where you want to be, but you're not where you used to be either. And I bet you if you look back on your life a year, 2 years, 3 years ago, you probably would have wanted to be in the position you're at now. The power thought card that's coming out for you, Jen. Loving others is easy when I love myself and accept myself. My heart is open. I allow my love to flow freely. I love myself. I love others. And others love me. Loving others is easy when I love and accept myself. Beautiful, Gemini, beautiful. So, Gemini, that is the message I have coming out for you guys for this month. Thank you guys so much for all the love and support. Thank you for liking, subscribing, sharing the content. You guys are all amazing. Again, if you want to get in on the extended version, the link is below in the description box. Otherwise, thank you guys again so much. And I look forward to seeing your beautiful souls again soon. Namaste.